Carnot cycle already we have discussed in our last class. Okay, so in our Carnot cycle that was the reversible process. All the four steps also following the reversible process. So the for entropy expression, the mathematical expression of entropy from the Carnot cycle, already last year already we have developed it, that is dq by t, dq reversible by t. For the reversible process, the entropy will be dq reversible by t. And for the cyclic process, if we add the all entropy term in the Carnot cycle, there are four steps also. But for the two steps, there is no entropy changes, because entropy changes means entropy means dq by t. But for the second step and the third step, there is no value of the dq, there is no changes of the heat energy. So we can say that the dq by t, only we are getting the dq by t value from the first and third step. And for the cyclic process, the summation of entropy changes, that will be zero. For the cyclic process, cyclic reversible process, the summation of entropy change, that will be zero. That means, so that is the mathematical form of this also. So dq by t is equal to zero. Already last step, we have developed this relationship. So ultimately, we are writing here that for the reversible Carnot cycle, algebraic sum of dq by t, which is the entropy ratio, is zero. For the irreversible heat engine, last day probably we have started the discussion also, the for irreversible heat engine. So for irreversible process, the reversible process, we have got dq reversible by t, that is the ds value or the entropy changes value. But for the irreversible process, always we know that the work done value, the work done for reversible process is always higher than the work done for irreversible process. Am I right? The work done for reversible process is always greater than work done of irreversible process. So considering this relationship of the work done, last day probably again we have developed the relationship Q2 by T2 minus Q1 by T1 for irreversible process, that is less than is equal to zero. For the reversible process, that was zero, but for the irreversible process, that will be less than zero. And because we know that it are reversible greater than it are irreversible, because work done output, that is the output, that will be greater than the irreversible work done also. So we can write that the efficiency for the reversible process of an engine is greater than efficiency of irreversible process for the engine also. So ultimately, we can sum up the relationship for a small irreversible cyclic process. Ultimately, we can write that dq by t less than zero, because in the last slide, we have seen that dq2 by t2 minus dq1 by t1, that is less than zero. So ultimately, summation of this, the changes of entropy, that will be less than zero for irreversible process. So from these two discussion, we have got that for reversible process, summation of dq by t is equal to zero if it is the cyclic process. But for the irreversible process, summation of dq by t, that is less than zero. Is it right? So there are two expressions for entropy, for reversible and irreversible process. Reversible cyclic process, dq by t is equal to zero. Irreversible cyclic process, summation of dq by t less than zero. So from these two expressions, we can write combinedly in this way also, dq by t less than is equal to zero. That is applicable for the reversible and irreversible.
Sir, some students are waiting.
Yes. Hello.
Some students are waiting.
Okay. So we can write for the reversible and irreversible commonly by this equation also, summation of dq by t less than is equal to zero. That is applicable for the reversible and irreversible process, less than zero for the irreversible process, is equal to zero for the reversible process. Is equal to zero for reversible process and less than zero for irreversible process. And that is also known as the Clausius inequality. So definition of entropy, physical explanation of entropy, physical significance of entropy, we will not discuss again. Already we have discussed what is the physical significance, what is the definition also. So last day probably we have discussed entropy of vapor, entropy of liquid and solid, that will be the order. Entropy of vapor is much more greater than the entropy of liquid, is much more greater than the entropy of solid. Because we know that the intermolecular attraction force in the solid is maximum. There is maximum attraction force. So if there is maximum attraction force, obviously the disorderness or randomness will be affected, right? But in the vapor state, so we can ignore the attraction also. In a closed container, so only the vapor will stay. Otherwise, if you open the lid of the container, cover of the container, so automatically it can mix with the rest of the environment also, atmosphere also. That is the vapor. So that we can ignore the attraction force, intermolecular attraction force in the vapor. So the randomness or disorderness will be maximum. But in the solid, there is the maximum intermolecular attraction force. So the disorderness or randomness will be minimum. So that will be the order of the entropy changes. So entropy of vapor is much more greater than the entropy of liquid. And again, it is much more than the entropy of solid. Now we'll calculate the entropy changes of universe for the reversible process, for the irreversible process. So universe means, what is universe? So system plus surrounding, that will be the universe. The system plus surrounding, that will be universe. So how the entropy changes of the universe will be made? So if we measure the entropy changes of system, if we calculate the entropy changes of surrounding, so after that, if we add the two, so we will get the entropy changes of universe also. So first, for the reversible process, entropy changes for the reversible process. Very simple. Suppose we have considered one system, and the system is receiving some amount of energy from the surrounding also. The system is receiving some amount of energy from the surrounding. So suppose that when the system is receiving some amount of energy, suppose the dq amount of the q2 amount of the energy also receiving from the surrounding. So for the system, this amount of energy, heat energy, will be gained by the system. So the changes of entropy, if it is the reversible, the changes of entropy will be dq by dq2 by the t2. Are you understanding? The system, so to calculate the entropy change in reversible process, I am telling that first we have considered one system which is receiving Q2 amount of heat energy from the surrounding, right? When the system is receiving this amount of energy for the system, so this amount of energy will be gained by the system. So we are writing that plus dq2 by t2 for the system. That will be the changes of entropy. What will be the changes for the surrounding? That will be same. Suppose we are considering the for the surrounding, the changes is q1. So we are writing that is dq1 by t1. So for the for the surrounding, we can write in this way also. System is receiving dq2 by the t2. So for the surrounding, it will be minus dq2 by the t2 also. Are you understanding my point? For the system is receiving q2 amount of heat energy from the surrounding. So for the system, so heat energy will be gained by the system. So we can consider positive. So plus dq2 by t2 for the system. But for the surrounding, or you can write only t also, there is no problem. For the surrounding, so from the surrounding we are taking the heat energy. So for the surrounding, so surrounding is losing the heat energy. So for that surrounding, it will be minus dQ2 by T2. So for the universe, system plus surrounding, minus dQ2 by the T2 plus dQ2 by T2. So that will be zero. So for the universe, so it will be zero. System plus surrounding. So the same amount of energy,
sir,
which is a, yes, yes.
Students are waiting, sir, from long time. They can't join, sir.
So let them wait. So after a few minutes, I will leave from the class also. Today we are facing different type of problems. So we have also different meeting. So after a few minutes, I will leave. So who is interested to join the class after 15 minutes, 22 minutes? So how they will join? Next day they will enter. Next day where they will enter in the class. Okay. So, bola, yeah.
So they are requesting from long time.
Mohammad Sad, Rajib Khan, Mohammad Soil Khan. Those students. Or कोई नहीं आया क्या? So I am telling again for the reversible process, same amount of energy will be gained by the system. The amount of energy lost by the surrounding, that will be same. There is no changes. System plus surrounding, so that will be zero. There is no problem. But for the irreversible process. For the irreversible process, see, for the irreversible process, so we are writing in this way also. So for the reversible process, for irreversible process, for reversible process, du is equal to dq reversible minus dw reversible. For irreversible process, du is equal to dq irreversible minus dw reversible. From the first law of thermodynamics. From the first law of thermodynamics, we know that that is the mathematical expression, dq is equal to du plus dw, so du is equal to dq minus dw. For reversible, we are writing here reversible, reversible. For irreversible, we are writing here irreversible and here also irreversible. So, but we know that du is the state function. It is not dependent on the path. That may be the reversible, that may be the irreversible. Ultimately, the changes of internal energy, that will be same. That is the state function. So du for reversible process, du for irreversible process, that will be same. So we are writing that dq reversible minus dw reversible is equal to dq irreversible minus dw irreversible. So again we know that dw reversible greater than dw irreversible. Always we are taking help from this expression also. Already it is proved that dw reversible, work done for the reversible process, always is higher than work done of the irreversible process. So dq reversible, so if we know that dw reversible greater than dw irreversible, so we can say that dq reversible greater than dq irreversible from this expression. So again divided by t, we can say that dq reversible by t greater than dq irreversible by t. Okay, so first we have developed this relationship, dq reversible by t greater than dq irreversible by t. So now for the irreversible process, we are writing here that for the irreversible, so DS system dq reversible by t, again we are considering that the system is receiving q amount of heat energy from the surrounding, so the changes of entropy for the system will be dq reversible by t. Why we are writing the dq reversible by t? Again we know that the DS, the entropy changes, that is also the state function. The entropy changes will be also the state function. That is not dependent on the path. The path is the reversible or irreversible, that is no matter. So the changes of entropy, that will be same because that is the state function. Like the entropy change, changes of like the internal energy change, so changes of entropy also not dependent on the path. So for the reversible process and for the irreversible process, for the system which is very small with respect to the rest of the surrounding. For the system, we can consider that DS reversible or DS irreversible, both are same for the system because that is the state function. So we are writing again DS system is equal to dq reversible by t, right? But for the any emergency, suppose that class is there. So for the surrounding, DS system is equal to dq reversible by t. For the surrounding, DS surrounding is equal to, again that is minus because from the surrounding the heat energy also the losing, so we are giving the negative sign, so minus dq irreversible by t. For the size of the surrounding with respect to system, that is much more greater than the system also. For the surrounding, we are writing the dq irreversible by t. But again, del s inverse is equal to system plus surrounding. So inverse is equal to reversible t minus dq irreversible by t. But we know that that is greater than zero. Just in the last slide, we have seen that dq reversible by t minus dq irreversible by t, that value greater than zero. So we can write that del s inverse greater than zero for the irreversible process. All the irreversible process, generally the spontaneous process, after that we'll write that, we'll discuss the criteria of the spontaneous process with respect to the entropy also. So all the spontaneous process will be the irreversible process. So for the irreversible process, del s inverse greater than zero, changes of entropy for inverse, that will be zero. Okay, so that is the expression ds greater than is equal to dq by t. Already we have discussed here also for the reversible and the for irreversible. For the reversible is equal to, and for the irreversible that will be. So again, that is just I told you, that is the criteria for the spontaneous process. When del s changes of entropy greater than zero, all are important as the MCQ also, because we can expect that you will get the MCQ for your final exam. So when del s greater than zero, the process is the spontaneous, that is the irreversible process. It is indicating the irreversible process, del s greater than zero. Del s less than zero, the process is the non-spontaneous. So del s is equal to zero, the process is in equilibrium, neither spontaneous nor non-spontaneous. Del s is equal to zero, the process is equilibrium. Del s less than zero, the process is non-spontaneous. And in general cases, we are telling that when the del s value less than zero, it is very difficult to happen the process also. It is very difficult. If we get the del s value less than zero for a particular process, so we can say that it is very difficult. So many external factors or external effects also require to run the process. To run the process, so many external effects also the require. But del s is equal to zero for the equilibrium process, and in most cases we will see that del s greater than zero. Okay. So now, like the internal energy, enthalpy, so we'll discuss the properties of the entropy. So I told you that first we'll discuss two common properties, that is state function or path function, and it is extensive or intensive. So first tell me, it is extensive or intensive properties, the changes of entropy. Any idea for the entropy? It is extensive or intensive, or why?
Extensive.
Why? Why it is assigned as the extensive properties? Why we are telling that extensive properties, entropy changes?
Sir, amount of substance depends on amount of substance.
So entropy changes, randomness or disorderness. So it is always dependent on the matter also, amount of substance. When the amount of substance will be increased, obviously the entropy will be, the total entropy of the system will be increased also. when the amount of substance will be increased, so total entropy will be also increased. Clear? So this is extensive properties, and obviously this is state function. It is dependent on the initial and final state. It is independent on the path also. So that is the state function. So if it is state function, we are getting dS is a perfect differential or axial differential. Entropy increases when system absorbs heat, and it decreases due to rejection of heat. When a system is receiving some amount of energy, obviously the kinetic energy will be increased. The movement of the particle in the system, that will be increased. Obviously the randomness or disorderness will be increased. So we can say that entropy increases when system absorbs heat, and just opposite, it decreases due to rejection of heat also, right? When heat, when heat absorption is nil, so obviously that is dQ is equal to zero. So we can say that there is no changes of the entropy also, because we know that entropy dS is equal to dQ by divisible by T. So if there is no value of the dQ, so obviously the dS value will be zero. In isothermal reversible process, just we have determined dS is equal to dQ by T, and in isothermal irreversible process, dS greater than dQ by T. These are the characteristics of entropy also. State function, extensive properties, perfect differential, and when the entropy will be increased, when the entropy will be decreased also. Okay, and what will be the mathematical expression for the entropy of reversible process and of irreversible process. So now, entropy is a state function, that is the one just explanation, so we will not discuss. Now we'll develop the how the entropy changes will be calculated. We know that entropy changes means dQ reversible by T. Entropy changes dQ reversible by T, but how it will be measured, dQ reversible by T. So dQ reversible means for the first law, dU plus dW reversible, and dQ reversible, that is when the temperature is constant, so there is no changes of internal energy zero, plus RT ln V1 by plus V2 by V1. What is this? What is this? So how we have written it? Ln V1 plus V2 by V1. That is work done for the isothermal reversible process. Work done for the isothermal reversible process. Initially, suppose some ideal gas molecule present in V1. Now, the V1 chamber is connected with V2. So now the gas molecule can move V1 to V2. So the total volume will be now V1 plus V2. Are you understanding or not? To get the expression, we are doing one just a simple experiment. Suppose initially some ideal gas molecule present in a container with which volume is the V1, right? So now this container is connected with another container which volume is V2. And if we open the cork, stop cork, so the gas molecule, the ideal gas molecule can go from the V1 to V2. So they can, the gas molecule now can move V1 to V2, V2 to V1. So we can consider that the present volume of the gas molecule will be V1 plus V2. So just we have developed the work done relationship in the reversible isothermal process, which is RT ln V2 by V1. RT ln V2 by V1, here V2 means V1 final volume by initial volume. The final volume is V1 plus V2, initial volume is V1. So it will be, and that when the temperature is constant, so there is no changes of internal energy, so we have zero. dQ reverse RT ln V1 plus V2 by V1. So delta S system is equal to dQ reversible by T. So delta S system is equal to RT ln V1 plus V2 by V1 divided by T. So T, T both will be cancelled. That is the final expression. So delta S system is equal to RT ln V1 plus V2 by V1. So in that way, we can calculate the entropy changes. our main target to determine the value of entropy changes. It is positive or negative. To identify the process which is spontaneous or non-spontaneous, so del S value is important also. How it will be calculated for a particular process, we can measure easily the V1, V2 value also, the volume also. What is the value of the V1, what is the value of V2? So if we know the volume value of the V1 and V2, easily we can measure the changes of entropy also. And I told you that that is also another important parameter to identify the process is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. That is our main objective or aim to discuss the thermodynamics in chemistry. To identify the process, all the process that may be the physical or chemical, to identify the process which is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. That is our main criteria. Okay, so for the entropy, if we know the V1, V2 value or the initial and final volume, so we can measure the entropy changes of the systems also. Okay, so in irreversible isothermal expansion of gas, del S inverse is equal to del S system plus del S surrounding, and del S surrounding actually that is for the system again we can write the same expression just we have got for the reversible process, but for the surrounding we have determined that that is zero. Actually that is that we are considering as zero. So for the irreversible process, the delta S inverse that will be also zero. So there is no changes for the surrounding also. So plus minus, there will be plus minus. So we are writing that that will be the value of the entropy changes for inverse. Okay, that is also important. So now to determine the entropy changes, we can write that RLN final volume by initial volume. RLN final volume by initial volume. Okay, so that is the entropy changes of a process, RLN final volume by initial volume. Okay. So that is the conclusion. So entropy changes of ideal gas. So next day we will discuss it, and after that entropy changes of ideal gas, and after that we will discuss that that is very, very important. So what will be the entropy changes for mixing of two or more than two ideal gas? First we will determine the entropy changes, what will be the value for entropy changes of ideal gas. After that we will determine what will be the entropy changes of two or more than two ideal gas. Right, so next we will discuss it. Number one.
Present, sir.
Two.
Present, sir.
Rule number three. Four.
Present, sir.
Four. Five.
Present, sir.
Five. Present.
Six.
Present, sir.
Okay. Six. Seven.
Present, sir.
Seven. Eight.
Present, sir.
Nine.
Present, sir.
Ten.
Present, sir.
11.
Present, sir.
12. 13.
Present, sir.
14.
Present, sir.
15.
Present, sir.
16.
Present, sir.
17.
Yes, sir.
18. 19.
Present, sir.
Sir, 8 present.
20.
Present, sir.
21, 22, 23.
Present, sir.
24.
Present, sir.
25.
Present, sir.
26.